Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to quickly and easily create the Orton Effect, which adds a soft, subtle glow to photos. The Orton Effect is named after Canadian photographer Michael Orton, who in the mid-1980s created it by overlapping two or more images of the same scene with very different exposures on slide film. The Orton Effect is mainly used in landscape photography, but it can be very effective on portraits as well. Open a photo you'd like to use for this project. I downloaded this one and the others from Shutterstock. The first step is to convert it into a smart object, so we can modify it non-destructively, as well as replace it with a different photo without having to add new filters. Click the icon at the upper right of the Layers panel, and click Convert to Smart Object. We'll make a copy of it by pressing Ctrl or Command J. Go to Filter, Blur, and Gaussian Blur. I'll blur it 5 pixels, but feel free to adjust the blur radius depending on the resolution of your image as well as its overall brightness and contrast. This particular image is 150 pixels per inch. I'll reduce the opacity of this layer to 30%, but again, feel free to tailor the amount to your specific image. Next, we'll adjust the brightness and contrast of the blurred layer. To do this, click the adjustment layer icon and click Levels. Because adjustment layers affect all the layers below them in the Layers panel, we'll need to clip it or restrict it to the blurred layer. To do this, click the Clipping Mask icon or go to Layer and create Clipping Mask. Drag the input highlights to the left until you like the amount of glow in your image. You can also drag the input shadows or the input midtones as well, but I don't like doing that because it eradicates the subtle nuances in those dark tones. As I toggle before and after we applied the Orton Effect, we can see the difference. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.